Welcome back. I'm Drone Tech, and we're going to watch Jim Acosta get manhandled by Matt Schlapp over at CPAC. But first, this quick message from healthwithdronetech.com. New studies show that by the time people reach their middle ages, the body often produces less than half the collagen it did in youth. Collagen is the main building block in our skin, making up 70 to 80% of it. This is why we get sagging skin and wrinkles as we age. If you want to look younger, you must supplement collagen. That's exactly why I highly recommend healthwithdronetech.com. Ageless Multicollagen is a powerhouse of the right ingredients to improve your youthful appearance quickly and effectively. Get my favorite multicollagen for 51% off today by going to www.healthwithdronetech.com or by visiting the link in the description or pinned comment.
You just told me that that's actually not right. You just told me that there was illegal voting in the last election. You don't know how many. Did you sit down with the team in Nevada? Let me finish. Did you sit down with the team in Nevada or Georgia, these states, and ever go through the binders of information that good patriotic Americans came up with?
But
did you ever talk
to overturn the results of the election?
How could you know that when you don't know the number?
Don't you just love how CNN and Jim Acosta and Democrats give themselves the ability to question any election they want to? But if you have any questions about elections that Democrats win, well, you're just an insane conspiracy theory monster. Here, Jim Acosta is getting indignant that anybody would question the previous election when he himself did that very thing for the last 4 years. Oh, but don't you know, claiming the election was hacked by Russia and stolen is completely different than being a Republican and claiming the election was stolen.
Are
Joe
you
Biden
that good
won
at math?
By 7 million votes.
I love how you're
306
thinking.
Electoral votes. How is it that there's just no way that that's
possible? What I'd like you to do is to read Time Magazine and to read the New York Times and to read the Washington Post, where they're saying it's less than 100,000 votes that separated the two men electorally. And you just said that conservatives spur violence, but you can't use any words. You admit that there's illegal voting.
I didn't say all
voting.
Conservatives, but
you
I said there were Trump supporters.
You said that there's
sure.
illegal.
Okay, wait. His claim is that Trump somehow inspired the violence at the Capitol, but he has no idea what words Trump actually said that did that. Then claims that his evidence for this is that there were Trump supporters at the Capitol. Oh, really? Well, as we all know by now, there were a lot of Biden Democrat Party supporters there as well. At least one of them was there with the goal of inciting violence, which he did on video, and then got paid for it by CNN and MSNBC.
How much? But you are certain
isn't
what the
this,
impact
isn't
was.
This the big lie conference?
That's what the Nazis used to say, Jim, you're better than that. You're better than that.
You're comparing
me to a Nazi.
No, I'm not. I'm
yes,
saying this
are.
Is the big lie conference.
You lie really
I love you, man. I'm
wow.
glad
you
you're here.
Do you feel responsible at all?
I'm glad you're
the
here.
Because
right. you're just wrong. You're just woefully wrong.
From the disinformation that CNN ran, do you feel responsible?
Oh my God, you see what I mean? He's so dishonest. He's clearly trying to connect these people to the Nazis. And then when he's called on it, oh no, that's not what I'm doing. Why else would you accuse them of telling a big lie? Something that is well known as a Nazi propaganda tactic. If we're going to talk about big lies, how about the one that the media told for the last 4 years? That Trump lost the election and it was stolen by Russia. That's all we heard, and it all started with the Steele dossier. What was the Steele dossier? It was Russian disinformation put together by a Russian spy who the FBI called a national security threat. But no, it was a big lie that was repeated over and over again by the media. Remember this exchange between Acosta and Trump when Acosta asked him about the Steele dossier?
I think it was disgraceful that the intelligence agencies allowed any information that turned out to be so false and fake out. I think it's a disgrace. And I say that. And that's something that Nazi Germany would have done and did do. I think it's a disgrace. That information that was false and fake and never happened got released to the public.
Can you give us a question?
Go
since
ahead.
You're, no, Mr. President-elect.
Go ahead.
President-elect,
go ahead.
Since you are attacking
no,
our news
not you.
Organization,
not you.
Can you give us a chance?
Your organization's terrible.
You are attacking our news organization.
Your organization's
can you give
terrible.
Us a chance
Let's
to
go.
Ask a question, sir.
Go ahead.
Sir,
quiet.
Can you state,
quiet.
Mr. President-elect.
Go ahead. She's asking a question. Don't
Mr.
be rude.
Mr. President-elect, can you give us a question?
Don't be
you're
rude.
Attacking us. Can you give us a question?
Don't be rude. No, I'm not going to give you a question. I'm not going to give you a question.
Can you
are fake news.
Oh, what a surprise. Jim Acosta ended up being totally wrong, and Trump ended up being 100% correct. I can think of another great example of Jim Acosta being an arrogant twat and then ending up being completely wrong. Remember the exchange between Jim Acosta and Trump during that infamous press conference? conference after Charlottesville, Trump claimed that the same warped logic being used to tear down Confederate statues would eventually be used to take down Washington and Jefferson. Jim Acosta mocked this idea and claimed, get this, that Trump needed to go back to history class and that this proved that he's a white nationalist.
Felt very comfortable espousing some views that are very, I mean, I would say they're almost white nationalist light, in that he was complaining, bemoaning the removal of Confederate statues across the country and asking whether or not George Washington and Thomas Jefferson are next. Those symbols of the Confederacy caused so much hurt, caused so much pain for so many Americans across the country. It is really understandable to most level-headed, rational Americans that these kinds of monuments, these kinds of symbols eventually just need to come down, and to compare them to George Washington and Thomas Jefferson, the president perhaps needs a refresher course, needs to go back to History 101.
I think that's all I have to say about this one. It's nice to see good people standing up against corrupt bullies like Jim Acosta, who literally lied to the faces of the American people for a paycheck. If you enjoyed it, please hit that like button, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to hit that bell icon as well, and I'll see you all next video.